I first saw these touch tools on Instagram. I saw probably three or four different ads every time I scrolled through my Instagram feed. These companies don't make specific claims that you're going to be healthy if you use these tools. I don't think they legally can, but they pretty much imply that if you use this, you're not going to get coronavirus. So these touch tools all have the same basic design. They're all kind of like a key or a hook. So they have a finger hole and then they have some sort of hook. The idea is that you can hold on to it and then open a door or press an elevator button. They're all made of brass or copper, which are antimicrobial materials. This is the keychain touch tool from Peel. It's one of the ones I saw advertised on Instagram most heavily. In addition to having the hook and the finger hole, it actually has a bottle opener as well. And it costs $35. So it's not cheap, but it is pretty heavy, pretty substantial feeling. And then this is the germ key that we found on Amazon. It goes for $15. It's actually a lot thinner than the Peel touch tool, but it has the same general design. In April of this year, the New England Journal of Medicine published a study. They were testing to see how long the coronavirus lived on different materials. They found that on stainless steel and glass, it can live for up to 3 days. But on copper, they didn't measure any after 4 hours. So that's a big difference. Our major concern here with these touch tools is that you can't expect to be totally safe just because you're using one. And say you do touch a surface that has coronavirus on it with your touch tool, and then you put that touch tool back in your pocket or back in your bag, it could potentially transfer the virus to another surface where it may live longer than on the copper. Of course, we're not saying that's going to happen every time or even that it's likely. You know, to be clear, it's better to have some sort of in-between when you're touching surfaces. But in general, we think that using a disposable glove that you can just toss after you use it and not worry about putting it back in your bag or putting it somewhere where it might expose you is a better idea. Overall, we don't think you need to go out and buy a touch tool to keep yourself safe from COVID-19. So if you're going to use one of these touch tools, make sure that you do wash it with an antimicrobial solution like rubbing alcohol after you do. Don't just toss it right back in your bag. No matter what you're using, if you're using a touch tool or gloves, be sure to continue to wash your hands for 20 seconds after you touch a surface. It's good practice. And if you can't, use hand sanitizer, but wash your hands when you can.
And that's why we think you don't need to go out and buy a brass touch tool to keep yourself safe from COVID-19.
Nailing it.